If you're looking for a great value for money broadband service, you have to get it from the right place. The place that gives you the benefits of high-speed broadband delivery, as well as exciting movie trailers, extensive sports coverage, and the very latest music videos. So where's all this available for one all-inclusive monthly fee?
Go on, where do you think?
Call now for your free broadband information guide.
Ashamed of your mobile? Then get yourself a new one on T-Mobile and save up to 75% in the massive Phones For You sale now on. We'll find the right phones for you.
Accident!
No, sir, I need to see the doctor.
You'll have to fill up these forms in triplicate.
It's an emergency.
Raymond, how is the tennis elbow?
Right as rain.
You could never be too careful with elbow.
Doctor, what about my colonic irrigation?
If we took life as seriously as this, then we'd never have invented Malibu. It's seriously easy going.
The estimated waiting time is now 6 hours.
Does dry skin great on you? Discover new Garnier Body Cocoon, our first body moisturizer with microfruit oils. It melts into your skin, leaving it feeling smoother, enveloped in softness. New Garnier Body Cocoon. In 7 days, it's goodbye dry skin, hello soft caress. Garnier.
At Magnet, we make buying a new kitchen even more of a pleasure. Because our half-price sale is now on with an extra 10% off sale prices for a limited period only.
Save up to 60% in the court sale, plus an extra £300 on this Florentino sofa. Massive extra savings throughout the store.
If you smell gas, there's only one number you need to know. 0800 111 999.
Don't miss the amazing double savings at DFS. There's double the discount on a huge choice of special offers. So you save not once, but twice on all these sofas and many, many more. As well as double sale savings, everything comes with not one, not two, but 3 years free credit, and everything's free for a year. Hot foot it down for double the discount. That's today, including New Year's Day at DFS.
It's unmissable. The kind of cinema that can take your breath away. You must see this magical movie. The Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers.
It was a must-see drama everyone was really talking about.
Miss Mina?
We left Jackie carrying Jason's baby without his knowledge. Ian and Donna's daughter held to ransom, and Justice about to catch up with Tanya. And now, they're at it again. New Footballers' Wives, soon on ITV1.
If you've ever tried to... Now, cravings can strike at any time. Nicotine CQ is the only clear patch that protects around the clock. So it's there when you and your willpower need it most. Nicotine CQ Clear. The only clear patch that protects you from cravings around the clock.
What is Baba Voom? This chili has more. Oh, yes. than this one. Weird, no?
No.
Okay.
On one person.
Oh, yes. But cool is not always with a boom.
No.
The Vava Voom. As the rabbit.
Is it Joie de Vivre?
Or is it...
What's the French for Vava Voom?
At B&Q, we've got a great selection of bedroom furniture, all at low B&Q prices. Just look at this beach effect bedroom set. It's an amazing £99 for the lot. There's a bedside table, a chest of drawers, and a wardrobe, all for under £100. But hurry, because when it's gone, it's gone.
Ashamed of your mobile? Then get yourself a new one on T-Mobile and save up to 75% in the massive phones for you sale now on. We'll find the right phones for you.
Save up to 60% in the court sale, plus up to an extra £200 off selected beds. Massive extra savings throughout the store.
My aim? Targeting wrinkles, firmer skin.
Revitalift from L'Oreal Paris with pro-retinol A nanosomes designed to target where wrinkles need it most. Appearance of even the most visible wrinkles and firms the skin in just 4 weeks. Revitalift from L'Oreal Paris, UK's best-selling anti-wrinkle cream.
What?
You haven't cleaned the flat.
Careful. Wow, babe. You
make my heart sing. Wow, thing, I think I love you. But I wanna know for sure.
When your throat feels like this, trust Strepsils Extra to numb the pain quickly. Strepsils Extra, first aid for sore throats.
Oh, breathtaking.
Now.
The plot.
My glasses. Somebody's moved them.
Well, they're not going to be in there, are they? You should have gone to Specsavers. You'd have got two pairs for the price of one then. Me and Gran did.
I got two pairs of bifocals.
Yeah, mine are varifocals.
You can get them free as well.
Oh, Dad!
Oh, you can clear that out now.
I told him to go to Specsavers.
There's a place where magic lives. To get there, visit disneyholidays.co.uk.
Nice place.
Yeah.
Big, huge leather
sofa.
Really posh.
Whereabouts?
Yeah.
Just over there.
Hello, Dave.
All right, Dave.
Fantastic.
While you're asleep, your cravings don't bother you. So try Nicorette Patch, the only patch designed just for waking hours. Beat cigarettes one at a time. You're twice as likely to succeed with Nicorette's 16-hour patch.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
vodka. I love my job.
Moben's big all-in January sale is now on, with every kitchen half price and a free integrated dishwasher. Call 0800 413 413. To crack the mind of the serial killer.
If the killer is that obsessed with Simon, they're not going to worry about anyone getting close to him anymore, are they?
Requires patience.
Maybe he killed himself to protect someone.
And female intuition.
I think you've got a pretty good idea who the killer is.
The Bill, New Year's Eve at 9, ITV1.
More truffle patty, Geoffrey.
You betcha.
Now, dig this, he talks to the animals, and what's more, they talk back. Tomorrow afternoon at 1, Rex Harrison stars as Dr. Doolittle. And later on tomorrow at 5, friends and family tell the John Thor story. And at 8, the much-missed actor is Inspector Morse in the final episode of the classic series, part of tomorrow's top lineup here on ITV1.
Can't stop, playmate. Val d'Isère.
ITV Christmas Entertainment, sponsored by Rennie.
West Side Story, New Year's Eve, 2:55, ITV1.
Hello and welcome to Malta. This is...
Hello.
Hello.
Cut. Welcome to Malta.
Great, how was the
dinner? Literally hundreds of churches with beautiful architecture.
Cut.
And friendly locals. Nighttime is where the Maltese really have a last for life.
Cut.
Malta is famous for its all-year sun and clear blue sea skies. Malta, you just have to join in.
Another holiday on the credit card, eh?
Yeah, my balance is really piling up. I should sort it out, but it's such a hassle.
You could get a Capital One No Hassle Platinum card.
Nah, who needs it?
Transfer your balance when you take out a Capital One No Hassle Platinum card and pay just 6.9% APR for the life of the balance. It's quick and easy.
What's in your wallet?
Ashamed of your mobile? Then get yourself a new one on T-Mobile and save up to 75% in the massive Phones For You sale now on. We'll find the right phones for you.
At Vision Express, we have thousands of frames, including designer names, at half price. Vision Express. Opticians.
Don't miss the amazing double savings at DFS. There's double the discount on a huge choice of special offers. So you save not once, but twice on all these sofas and many, many more. As well as double sale savings, everything comes with not one, not two, but 3 years free credit, and everything's free for a year. Hotfoot it down for double the discount. That's today, including New Year's Day, at DFS.
Home. A place of conquer love and clamper van hate. Where we invent the best sports in the world, then get good at playing them badly. At home, we like to do ourselves down, but we're pretty plucky when we want to be. We are John Lennon. We are the suffragettes. We are the man who invented the bobble hat. UK TV brings you home.
Think of all the great movies and games there have been this year. Movies like Minority Report, About a Boy, Ice Age, Blade 2, and games like Spyro 2 on PlayStation 2. Now think of this, rent any combination of any three films or games and only pay for two. And you can keep them for two nights. Three for two nights. Blockbuster, bringing entertainment home.
Carlsberg don't do holidays. But if we did, they'd probably be the best holidays in the world.
You know I'm a police officer.
The final investigation. Kevin Whateley and John Thorne.
It's about important things. Life and death. Regret.
This is how the story ends. The remorseful day. The last ever Inspector Morse. Monday, 8:30, ITV1.
At this time tomorrow on ITV1, John Thompson is Stan the Man. Now it's the weekend news with Nicholas Owen.
Good evening. The Prime Minister tonight intervened in the row over whether England's cricketers should play in Zimbabwe. Following a day of criticism from players, cricket officials and the Conservatives, Mr. Blair's written to the opposition leader Ian Duncan Smith. He says the government doesn't want the players to go, but still insists it's up to the cricket authorities to decide. Earlier, the England captain Nasser Hussain said that was ridiculous. Romilly Weeks reports.
A cricket captain, not a politician. Nasser Hussain's description of his job as he's dismissed as ridiculous any suggestion that his players should decide whether to tour Zimbabwe in February. In the Sunday Telegraph, he writes, "Going to Zimbabwe is a moral issue and a very important one, and it's not up to cricketers but to government politicians to make the decision." The regime in Zimbabwe is internationally condemned for human rights abuses. The Conservative Party says the government must show leadership over whether to call off the tour.
As a view, it's a very serious issue, and they should have spoken to the team, they should have spoken to the ICC, and they should be lobbying the Commonwealth. They're doing nothing, and now they're trying to weasel out of it. It's just not good enough.
Tonight, the Prime Minister has insisted that the government position is clear. In a letter to Ian Duncan Smith, he writes, "In the light of the deteriorating political and humanitarian situation in the country, ministers have made clear that if the decision were for them, England should not play in Zimbabwe." But John Reid from the England and Wales Cricket Board says he only heard the government's view through the media, and he's angry that ministers have not contacted the board directly.
Wider ramifications of England taking part in the World Cup need to be taken on board by the government, and the government needs to provide firm political leadership in this respect. So far, I'm afraid that hasn't happened.
In one of their toughest test series, the England team say they have no time to reflect on political judgment. Provide advice, but it won't make the decision. Combine sport and politics, it seems, and you have a game of pass the buck. Romilly Weeks, ITV News.
Parts of the historic West Pier in Brighton have collapsed into the sea. Its owners say there's still time to save it, but tonight it's not clear how much there'll be left to save. From Brighton, Dan Rivers reports.
After lying derelict for more than a quarter of a century, it seems Brighton's West Pier may have finally succumbed to the sea. This morning, a large section collapsed after the supporting cast iron piles gave way. 136 years after it was completed, one of Britain's most magnificent Victorian piers is now littering the beach, giving souvenir hunters a chance to take home a piece of engineering history, even if some don't quite realise what they've got.
These are notes from 1958 and 69. It's interesting things, like, I think they're train times.
Why? Well, as I say, basically it's for the grandchildren, something like this, pass on, and we've got a bit of the old Brighton Pier, and that's it.
A 4-7 gale is forecast tonight, and the beach is now closed to stop people scavenging.
When the chain pier collapsed over 100 years ago, the same thing happened then, the history books tell us. So it's inevitable in many respects. However, at the moment, it is extremely dangerous, and there's no doubt that more will be coming off the pier over the next 24 hours.
The pier had been damaged numerous times before, including during the 1987 storms. This, though, may well be the last straw. The huge 1920s ballroom is now hanging precariously over the surf. Well, as you can see behind me, the beach is absolutely littered with debris from the pier. Tomorrow, engineers will begin to assess whether the rest of the structure will have to be demolished. Dan Rivers, ITV News, Brighton.
Finally, a 27-year-old explorer, Tom Avery, is resting tonight after becoming the youngest Briton ever to walk to the South Pole. Terry Lloyd has his story.
As an 8-year-old boy, Tom Avery read about Scott and Shackleton's expeditions to the South Pole and promised himself he would follow them. Now aged 27, Tom has made it after a grueling 700-mile trek across Antarctica. From the South Pole, he spoke to me by satellite telephone.
Well, I've been fascinated by Captain Scott and his great polar adventures for years, and sort of since I was a young boy, it's been a dream of mine to reach this place, and to finally be here and be camping in a tent just 20 yards from the South Pole is quite a surreal feeling, but it feels great.
What sticks in my mind from my time down there are the really hostile conditions. Did you face much danger?
We did have crevasse problems at the beginning, the first couple of days climbing up from the edge of the continent. There were some pretty big ones, and Patrick and I did fall into a couple, but they sort of disappeared after the first few days.
Back home in Sussex, Tom's parents and brother cracked the ice-cold champagne to celebrate. He's no stranger to adventures. He conquered one previously unclimbed mountain and named it after his mother.
One of the particular attractions of the South Pole is how few people have actually got there, and he wanted to be one of those few. And there's still Everest to climb, but I hope that this South Pole expedition is enough for the time being, but who knows?
He'll leave behind the sub-zero climate and be back home next month. Terry Lloyd, ITV News.
And that's it. The ITV News channel can keep you up to date with developments at home and abroad. From me and the weekend team here, good night. Do have a good week.
ITV National Weather, sponsored by PowerGen. PowerGen, power in good hands.
Good evening. So the rain slowly pushing northwards, although not reaching quite the very far north of Scotland. At the same time, drier slots across the southern half of England and Wales. Misty and murky, although no problems on temperatures. A cloudy start for the new week tomorrow, but still further rain for Northern Ireland, southern Scotland and northern England. The best really of any brightness across the southern half of the country. But even again here, the risk of some heavy showers. That's where you'll find the mildest temperatures, 11 or 12, but struggling across the east of Scotland and the northeast of England, 6, that's 43. Now that's really only a taste of what's to come, as by Tuesday, cold air pushing right the way across the country. So a little bit on the nippy side.
Power Gen. Power in good hands.
I've been at GMTV since the very start, so 10 years. And when I look back, I think the thing that makes me laugh the most, the hair and some of the specs. Eek! Very frightening. 10 fantastic years, I think I've got the perfect job.
Sacre bleu, freedom to do whatever you want, and we mean anything. And because free serve is now the biggest, the UK's number one, that freedom of expression is in more homes up and down the country than anyone else. But snap it up now, because free serve anytime is only £6.99. That's right, half price for your first 3 months. So join the freedom movement and join free serve by visiting freeserve.com or these stores.
When I press this button, that's it. Gone. Finished. Forever.
Let's do it.
There are people out there, good people, making sure that you only ever pay for the energy you use.
Horm is a rock in the middle of the stormy Atlantic on the same latitude as Moscow. And the people at Horm seem shocked that we don't get the same weather as Morocco. We're supposed to be posh, but we're not. We drive while picking our noses. Our sense of humour is cruel, our music is cool, and we make the best fruit puddings in the entire world. UK TV brings you home.
If you're
your fingers on the pulse of cool, phone now and join the club, where you'll get the chance to create the most desirable venue in town, and we'll get to watch you on telly.
Are my lips really that orange?
Stand by for Celebrity Impressions with a Difference.
How's it going, big man?
What is the same to that guy? Which was really going nowhere.
All new, alter ego, New Year's Eve at 10, ITV1.
Our movie at 1am is the epic French period drama Les Misérables. Now drama on the... ...comes up the premiership. The Premiership on ITV, sponsored by Coca-Cola.
It's a beautiful day to let it get away. It's a beautiful day. Oh, oh, oh. Touch me. Take me to that other place. Touch me.
Welcome to a wet and wintry Highbury and a pivotal day in the Premiership. Arsenal looking to go 7 points clear at the top versus Liverpool looking for their first league win in 9 games. We'll also have the best of Newcastle versus Tottenham later, but we start right here. Your commentator for Arsenal against Liverpool is Clive Tyldesley.
The gulf that has recently grown between the two teams may have widened with the day's team news. Arsenal's nearest damage to full strength with Robert Pires returning and Kanu preferred to Francis Jeffers, who sits alongside Dennis Bergkamp on the bench.
So, after the tale of two penalties here at Highbury, Arsenal's lead is 5 points at the top rather than seven. Still healthy and still everything to play for all of those involved in the race for the Premiership title. Don't forget to join us on New Year's Day for a roundup of all the action at 10:45. All that remains to say then is a Happy New Year to you all.
Premiership on ITV, sponsored by Coca-Cola.
Next Sunday, the battle lines are drawn in love and war.
Don't make me shoot you, sir!
Hornblower returns on a brand new adventure.
Sorry, I have my duty.
Ewan Griffith, Robert Lindsay, Paul McGann, Greg Wise, Lawton Cranich and Julia Sawala.
Truly are a good friend, Ryan.
I hope I'm more than that, sir.
A brand new Hornblower, next Sunday at 9, ITV1.
Mike Bate said business inquiries would often be
rerouted through a dedicated advice centre.
This is Linda speaking, Kelly speaking.
This is Julie speaking, how can I help?
Translation. I'll get sent round the houses. All right, Treacle, slow down. I won't turn the meter on till you get in the cab, promise. I thought, there's got to be another way. And there was.
Thanks.
Oh, cheers, love. Want my tip? Try another bank.
There's more for your place at Our Place in MFI's biggest ever sale. More outstanding value kitchens and appliances with up to 50% off, plus an extra 20% off all sale prices. All styles, all finishes, all up to you.
Shall I go for the granite?
You decide at MFI's biggest ever sale.
For every good in the universe, there is an evil.
I must deactivate you. You are dangerous.
And the only way to conquer it is to face it.
I'm a mirror for you as well.
Don't be so vain.
Now, a generation's final journey begins. Star Trek Nemesis.
Home. A place of conquer love and clamper van hate. Where we invent the best sports in the world, then get good at playing them badly. At home, we like to do ourselves down, but we're pretty plucky when we want to be. We are John Lennon. We are the suffragettes. We are the man who invented the bobble hat. UK TV brings you home.
If you smell gas, there's only one number you need to know. 0800 111 999.
Save up to 60% in the court sale, plus an extra £300 on this Florentino sofa. Massive extra savings throughout the store.
Enjoy every curve. There's a place where magic lives. To get there, visit disneyholidays.co.uk.
Ashamed of your mobile? Then get yourself a new one on T-Mobile and save up to 75% in the massive Phones for You sale now on. We'll find the right phones for you.
It's got to be our place for hundreds of beds, all with 50% off, plus an extra 20% off all sale prices at MFI's biggest ever sale.
Bringing cinema to life, whatever the weather. London weather at the weekend. Sponsored by Warner Village Cinemas.
Good evening. Well, it really did turn out to be a very groggy, damp day, and it's not really much of a surprise when you take a look at the satellite. A mountain of clouds sitting right across the whole of the country today, and that's going to really, really take its time clearing. So any improvements over the next 24 hours will be very, very slow. Saying that though, tonight most of that rain will start easing back. At the same time, misty, murky conditions coming through, but very mild on those temperatures. Lows of 9, that's 48 in Fahrenheit. Now a little bit of an improvement tomorrow, if any, some drier slots, not really much in the way of brightness, always the risk of showery rain again, but with the winds coming from a southwesterly direction, still very, very mild for this time of year. Highs of 11, that's 52 in Fahrenheit. Now a bit of a change come Tuesday, those winds swinging round this time to a northeasterly direction, so really coming down around 5 maybe 6 degrees, and again always the risk of some showers. Over the next few days they gradually start coming up again, the temperatures highs of maybe 8 or 11, but with that I'm afraid a little bit more in the way of rain.
London weather at the weekend, sponsored by Warner Village Cinemas.
Million crimes are committed every year in the UK. Some are more shocking than others. The murder of Damilola Taylor, senseless violent carjackings, attacks on young children. Should we punish to deter others, or should our system of justice reflect other values, including mercy and forgiveness? Should the punishment fit the crime? Tonight's ultimate question. Hello and welcome to Ultimate Questions. Tonight we're examining another of the key moral, ethical and spiritual issues few of us can ignore. In the 1960s, John McVickar was an armed robber who was tagged public enemy number one. But since then, he has spent far more time as a writer on crime and justice, his most recent book being on the Jill Dando murder. Emma Restalore is Joint Chief of the British Druid Order and writer on ritual and natural spirituality. 50 years ago, she might have been imprisoned. 300 years ago, she could have been put to death in a gruesome manner. Peter Brunvels, who trained as a lawyer, was once a Tory MP with an unrivalled gift for self-publicity, and now he's a church commissioner. His uncompromising right-wing views have not, however, mellowed. Gerald Coates took the church out of religion when he founded the Pioneer Movement in his living room 30 years ago. He owns up to nothing more serious than a ticket for driving in a bus lane in London. Our panel, together with our invited audience, representing a cross-section of views and beliefs, are here to discuss the question, should the punishment fit the crime? John McVickar, should those who commit crimes be punished?
Of course, at its most simplest is that you punish in order to do justice. The victim must have a sense that society has punished those who have committed wrongs against him or her. You must also deter others who would do likewise. And last of all, you must also ensure that the severity of the sentence reflects the gravity of the offence. That's very, very important. In that sense, you're quite right to say that the punishment should fit the crime. But in our society, we are a civilised, democratic society, punishment should always be civilised and humane, because that expresses the best of our society. We never, ever, we should never, stoop to the level of the criminal and reduce ourselves to hanging and flogging and all sorts of other monstrosities that unfortunately go around them in other parts of the world are seen as justice.
Interesting that you talk about punishing for the victim.
Yes.
Is that the primary motive? Does that?
If you don't, and this is where those who are of a lenient persuasion, the victim or his survivors will take up the cause themselves. And you've got to remember that justice is about stopping other people taking up the law and prosecuting or punishing those who've done them wrong or their relations. We live in a just society, and a just society does not involve individual retribution. And society must exact its retribution. If it doesn't, it will resort to vigilante law.
And is punishment to protect society from the sort of person that you were 30 years ago?
I think you've got to be very careful. The criminal justice system is a very crude tool. It's the best one we've got, but you can't expect it to perform miracles. Crime has always been with us and always will be. But If you don't, it worked with you, didn't it? Well, it didn't. Well, let's go into that.
Maybe we ought to.
Well,
it's a long story.
Individual cases don't make good rules.
Right.
Okay, but if you don't punish justly, and if you punish leniently, you can encourage crime. So you must have proper punishment, which is, in a sense, I'm a retributionist.
Okay.